parasha of this week is the parasha of Bamidbar. The parasha of Bamidbar is parasha that Hashem gives to the Bnei Israel the opportunity to count how many they are. One question I have for you. Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu need to know how many we are? Hashem knows. Why Hashem want that each tribe to be counted? What is the reason? If you take the parasha of this week, honest, if you see the Odis parasha of Bamidbar, I mean, it's a big parasha. Only calculation where the Shevet of Yehuda will be camp, where he will camp, Issachar, where he will camp, Degem HaHanifrei, where he will be camping, how many people there are, each tribe, how many thousands there are. I mean, why did not the Torah said, with a resume, Bikitso, there are few hundred thousand, 600,000 Jews, that's it. Why the Torah is so, it's so large, it's so many psukim. There is a lot of mitzvot that the Torah didn't mention, the mitzvot, and here the Torah is talking about why, how many, each tribe, how many they were. You understand? This is the question that I was asking myself. We must know one thing, that each tribe, Reuben, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, each tribe, they had their own quality. And I think Hashem, he wanted that the Jews will count. Hashem wanted that the Jews, they will count themselves. How many each tribe, how many they were. And that was very important for Hashem, that each tribe will be counted. Why? Because Hashem wants that each Jew will learn the good qualities that the other tribe has. You understand? It's like the colors. There is a lot of colors. There is pink, there is yellow, there is red, there is white, there is black. And sometimes there is you make yourself a nice dress with all kind of colors. So there is a lot of kind of colors. The same way there is a lot of kinds of colors, there is a lot of kind of people. You understand me?
Yes.
I mean, we are not the same. Your name is David. My name is David, but we are not the same people. Everyone has his own quality. I have beard. You don't have beard. Yes, you have a small beard. I have a longer beard. But I have a longer, a big beard. But beard doesn't mean that I am better than you. There is people that have no beard. That's tzaddikim. You know, the beard. It's not the beard. It's not. It's not through the beard we know what you are. No, it's through your heart we know what you are. So you see, the Jews, they had all kind of colors. Even the flags, the flags, how do you call the flags? The drapeau, the flags that they have, they were colors, all kinds of colors. So Hashem wants to teach the Jews the same way that colors are different. There are different colors. And the tribes are different tribes, because the tribe of Shimon is not Levi. Levi is not Yehudai. You know what Arizal HaKadosh said? Arizal HaKadosh said that there is 12 gates in the Shamayim, in heaven. 12 gates. And each gate, it belongs to one tribe. There is the gate of Reuben, Shimon, Levi, Yehudai, Issachar. There is 12 gates. And each tribe has its own gate. So that means that the tribe, they are not the same. Each one has his own quality. But Hashem, he wants us to learn all the good qualities from each one of them. You understand?
Yes.
We have to take the best of each one. We have to take the best qualities from each one. We have to learn. We must have ambition. Ambition to grow. And to grow like to be a rich man. If you don't have ambition to be a rich man, you will not be a rich man. And the spiritual ambition must have bitachon, faith in Hashem, l'espoir, emunah, faith in bitachon, on HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to have the ambition to grow. Usually people have no ambition to be bad people. There is only good ambition to be good. What does that mean, ambition? Ambition, that means you have to grow. There is no ambition to get down. There is no limit to be ambitions. The Torah said, Moshe Rabbeinu alav shalom. Hashem, he said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, count the Jews. By counting the Jews, each Jew will learn from the other Jew something. Because when we count Jews, it takes time. By the time that it takes, so people, they must have the ambition not to be only what they are, they must have ambition to be more what they are. If I am Reuben, so I have to learn all the quality of Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, Issachar, Zvulon, Binyamin, you understand? When Moshe Rabbeinu went to the Shamaim, the Torah said, Alita lamarom shavita shivi lakachta matanot ba'adam. Moshe Rabbeinu went to the Shamaim, and then, when he arrived to the Shamaim, he took, they gave him presents. And the Malachim said, Ma lilu d'isha b'inenu. What this man is doing with us? I would like just to ask you one question. Why HaKadosh Baruch Hu did ask Moshe Rabbeinu come to the Shamaim? Why Hashem did not give the Torah to Moshe in earth? All the time that Hashem spoke to Moshe, Moshe was in earth. Moshe didn't need to go to the Shamaim. You know, the Malachim, they were surprised. When the angels, they saw Moshe up there, they said, "My little Dishabim, what does he do here? This is not his place. What does he do here? What does he do here? What is doing here?" They did not understand what he's doing there. So the question is, Behemet, they are right. Why did Moshe Rabbeinu have to go up there? You understand? Makom shel hevetia, the place up there, it's a dangerous place. It's a place that you can die. Why you have to go there? Why? You know what it is? The answer. Hashem, he wants to teach Moshe ambition, how to have ambition to grow and to be more than an angel. Do you understand? Not only to be a man. Hashem didn't want that Moshe Rabbeinu should be only a man. No. Hashem wanted that Moshe Rabbeinu, he must have ambition to grow. That's why Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, come up to the Shamaim. Shamaim, Hashem, why do you want you to go to the Shamaim? Maybe they kill me there. They will not kill you there. You think you are a man. You're not a man. You are something. You must have ambition to grow. Must have ambition not only to be a man, even that I am a man in earth, like a lot of tzaddikim, like Rabbi Chaim Pinto, Rabbi Chaim ben Attar. He was a man, yes or no? But he was like a malach. You know that the Shamayim, when Rabbi Chaim ben Attar, as long that he did not do the Havdalah, the Malachim, the Shamayim, they did not start to light the fire in Gehinnom. They will light the fire on Gehinnom only after the Orachaim HaKadosh do the Havdalah. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Ah. Ay. That's what Hashem wants to teach Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe, you are a human being. Yeah, but I want to teach you, Moshe. You must have ambition to achieve, to be a malach on earth. How can I be a malach on earth? So by coming up. Come up. I'm going to show you that you are more stronger than the malachim. You are more stronger than the malachim, that they will ask What do you do here? This is ambition. Hashem wants Moshe Rabbeinu to have ambition, not only to remain a man, but to be another man, to be a malach, a man and a malach. That's what the Torah said. Alita l'amaron, Moshe Rabbeinu went up to the Shamayim to receive the Torah. Lakachta matanot ba'adam. You took presents. Not what kind of presents you take, you took ba'adam. The self-ambition of the man. This is the gift that Hashem gives to the man. The gift that Hashem gives to the man, that a man can have ambition to achieve something that it's impossible to achieve. You understand? Like, I know in Venezuela, I know a man that he told me that when he was a young man, he has ambition to be rich. He saw rich people. And he said to his mother, Mama, one day we'll be millionaire. We'll be very rich. And she told him, yes, if you carry on with this ambition, one day you will be rich. And today he is one of the richest men in the world. You understand?
Because he had a big ratzon.
Because he has a big ratzon, ambition. If you have a big ratzon, you can be Moshe Rabbeinu. You understand? Now we understand why Hashem is saying to Moshe Rabbeinu, come up to the Shamayim, come up. Don't remain on the earth. Have ambition. Come to the Shamayim. You can achieve something. Because Hashem pushed Adam Moshe Rabbeinu to achieve, because the ambition, it's not a gift that He gives you from the Shamayim. The ambition is something that it's up to you, you understand? From the Shamayim, from heaven, they will help you to be a tzaddik. They will help you to achieve. But the ambition, they will not give you ambition. Like the Atshamayim. Everything is up to Hashem except your Atshamayim. Your Atshamayim, to fear Hashem, it's up to you. Ambition, it's your work. You understand? Yeah. Now, when the Kahta Matanot Ba'adam, HaKadosh Baruch Hu puts Adam, Moshe Rabbeinu, to achieve, to learn that Hashem showed him a way how he can achieve to be high what he is. He can achieve to be more than a malach. What? Ambition. Lakahta matanot ba'adam. Every man, he has this ability, this present on him, this matana that Hashem give on him, that through ambition, he can achieve something. And that was Hashem, you count the Jews. By counting Jews, the Jews will start to do discovery about each shevet, each color, each tribe, and by knowing each tribe, they will know all the quality, the good quality of each tribe, so they will have ambition not only to have the qualities that they have, but to have the qualities from all kinds of tribe. I would like to ask you one question.
Yes, sir.
Are you Israel or Levi or Kohen?
Israel.
Israel. Good. There is three kinds of Judaism. The Judaism is Israel, Kohen, and Levi. They are all Jews, but there is levels of Jews. The Kohen is the highest. The Levi is lowest than the Kohen and the Israel. What can we learn from Levi and a Kohen? To be like them. I want to be like... I mean, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, count the Jews. Through counting the Jews, they will learn about the quality of each tribe. I mean, if I belong to the tribe of Reuven, and I look up to the tribe of Levi, and can Levi be like them? Yes or no?
Never.
And if I look at the tribe of Yehuda, I can Levi be a king? Only from Yehuda there is kings.
Right.
So what can I learn from Yehuda or from Levi? But there is something that I want to teach you. From Yehuda I can learn How to be a king? What it is a king? A master. What is a king? A king, le roi. A king, somebody who, a boss. Somebody who give orders. A man who fight the Tzara and beat the Tzara is a king. Man malchei rabbanan. A man who supports Torah and mitzvot, he is a king. A man who studies Torah, he becomes like Shevet Levi. Because Shevet Levi, all their life was studying Torah. So that's what I can learn from Shevet Levi. Understand? What I can learn from the Kohanim, how to sacrifice myself for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. For the Levim, I learned how to be a good servitor to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, learning Torah. From Yehuda, I will learn Man Malchei Rabban, to be a king. But a king who beat the Yetzara. You understand?
Yes.
Now I understand. Each Shevet, each tribe in his quality. And each quality that he received from the Avodah Kedoshim. From the Avodah Kedoshim. Avodah Kedoshim. You know, Abraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, they have all good qualities, and they spread their qualities through their children. So each one learn from the other. You know, David HaMelech said, Mikol Melamida Iskati, I learn from everybody. Even from a bad man, I learn. I learn from children. I learn from everybody. So I show you what that the Jews, they will learn from each Jew. But each one must have the shifa, the volonté, la volonté, the ambition to be a Jew, a king in the Torah. A king in the Torah. And this is impossible. A man who supports the Torah, who studies Torah, he becomes like Shevet Levi. To have ambition to be king, a Kohen Gadol, it's possible. You understand me? You know what the Tzara does? When the Tzara sees you, that you are attached to Hashem, you wake up in the morning, and you have ambition to be a good Jew. So the Tzara, he starts to fight you. The Tzara starts to give you, to encourage, to décourager, to discourage you. How do you say décourager? He tried to discourage you. The Tzara, he can't stand a man with ambition. When he sees you have a spiritual ambition, he wants to discourage you. But don't forget one thing. The same way there is material ambition, you have to search for the spiritual ambition. Now we approach Matan Torah. And while approaching Matan Torah, we must have this spiritual ambition to receive more Torah than last year. More! Each man wants more. Each man wants more. Ambition to have more. So we must have this ambition to receive more Torah. But don't forget one thing. Ambition with limits. Ambition with limits. Don't ask something that you cannot have. Don't ask, I want to be right like Moshe Rabbeinu. And you don't go to study Torah. If you ask that you want to be like Moshe Rabbeinu, you have to study Torah. It's a good ambition. But you say, I want to be like Moshe Rabbeinu, and you don't study Torah, you don't do Torah, that this is a bad ambition. You understand? You understand me? An ambition with a beginning, so there is a good end. But if there is no beginning, what kind of ambition? It's a good beginning with the end. I would like to... I don't know if I told you, you know, I was last week in Toronto, in Chicago, and I went to Miami. And I had, Baruch Hashem, a very, very busy week. That's why I couldn't give you the show last week. Very, very busy week. A lot of tzarot, a lot of bad news, you know, I heard too much problems. But One thing made me happy. One thing that I saw, it made me happy. When I was in Chicago, and when I was in Toronto, when I went to the first minyan to pray, I saw a lot of Bati Midrashot, full of people. People woke up at 5 o'clock. I was so happy. People that all day, they work, but they start their day with a dafayomi. That made me happy. It's a good ambition. Ambition to remain a good Jew. Because the Satan is very big. The Satan, he wants to discourage the people. I have here, I don't know if I told you this story. I have here in Paris. I don't know. It's something incredible. You know, I was. I saw one of the biggest miracles in my life. You know, there was a man who went to ski.
Yes.
And he did a bad accident. By doing this ski, he did a bad accident, and he was in a big coma. And the doctor said to his parents, he's finished. His brain is finished. There is nothing we can do. And they asked the parents if they can disconnect him, because he was living only
life support machine.
Yeah, force machine.
Life support machine.
Yes, life support machine. So they asked me what to do. I said, no, you're not allowed. As long, no. I said, no, you should not do that. And then, I was in Marseille, and I told them to come to see me in Marseille. And the parents came, and they give a shiur for his refuah. And he was only 20 years old, this man. And I said, Be'ezrat Hashem, and the father, it was not a big Baal Emunah. It was not, but you see, when there is a problem, everybody become, they have no, now he has no, I mean, now he's trying everything. I mean, even if he has no Emunah, now he must, they told him, now we have only Hashem. The doctor said, there is nothing we can do. So now he came to see me. So I said, do you believe in Hashem? He told me, well, now I believe in Hashem and I want to believe more. Now what I should do, to do me a favor. This is the only baby I have. I want, please, I pray Hashem. So we give a shiur. And we prayed, we said to him, Baruch Hashem, 2 weeks ago, he woke up. He woke up, David, he woke up. All France talk about this big miracle. Even the doctors, they don't understand. They don't understand. This is the koach of the Emunah. This is the koach of the Emunah. The strength of the Emunah. And that's what Hashem wants us. Ambition and Emunah. Look, this man. This man, I mean, he was... for him, everything was lost. But there is no ambition here, because there is place where you can have ambition. Here, there is no ambition. This is death and life. This is not up to him. But there is another kind of growing emun on Hashem, growing tefillah to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. When a man, I would like to tell you this, it's very important for you to know that.
Yes.
That the only way to have ambition for good things, if really you have ratzon, you have willing,
yeah.
You have emunah.
How do you build the ratzon?
Huh?
How do you make your latsum stronger? How do you build your latsum?
Well, as I told you before, Lakahta Matanot Vayadam, this is the gift that Hashem gives to the man. And they are on the man. On the man, he has this kohot. Lakahta Matanot Vayadam. Can you imagine? HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to Moshe Rabbeinu, come up. I mean, what does that mean, come up? What does that mean, come up? I mean, up there, it's a fire. If I come up there, I'll die. But Moshe Rabbeinu, Alav Shalom, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, don't worry, you come up. You must have the ambition not only to remain a man, you must have ambition to become from a man, to become a malach, to become an angel. And you will walk with the angels. Even that you are Basav Adam, even that you are only a human being. This is the ratzon, this is the willing, this is the ambition. Like Ahtam Matanot Ba'adam, because HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives this kohot in the man. A man, he has this koah, he has this weapon that Hashem creates on the man. Just the man, he don't see them. A man saying, how can I do? How can I become? How can I do that? No! You can. If you want, you can. Yes, you can. If Abraham Abinu did what he did, I can do. The Gemara said that the Avot HaKadoshim said, Matai yagi'u ma'aseh yadai ma'aseh avotai. If each Jew, he should say, when I will achieve to do like my parent did? How can I do like my parent did? How can I do like what Abraham Abinu did? How can I do like Yitzhak Abinu did? It's impossible. Yes, ambition. A good ambition. There is bad ambitions. If there is mahluket, like Korah. Korah had bad ambitions. He wanted to be Kohen Gadol. He wanted the place of Moshe Rabbeinu. That is a bad ambition. Understand? You must have ambition on something that it's good for you, good for others. It's ambition that it's suitable. It's good for everybody. But not an ambition that there is a war. There is a mahloket there. You understand?
Yes.
Look at the daughters of Tzlofchad. When they came to Moshe, and they said to Moshe, our father died, and he has no children, he has no boys, he has only girls. So that means that we don't have an heritage in Israel. We don't have a piece of land for our, that we can put there the name of our father, because Israel was divided to all the tribes. So they said, well, where can we go? Where we will go? We don't have a piece of land. Because each family, they receive a place in Israel. What about us? Ambition. Can you imagine how many women they were that they had no heritage in Israel? And no one dared to ask Moshe Rabbeinu. And thus, they asked Moshe Rabbeinu. You know what happened at the end? Hashem, he gave them. They got what they wanted. Ambition to have. Who could dare? Which woman can dare? Ah, I'm going to go to Moshe and ask a piece of land. They were, because women at Tzniut, no one dared to ask Moshe Rabbeinu. And those had a good ambition. When you have a good ambition, you succeed at the end. A bad ambition, there is problems with bad ambitions. Sh'ifa. A good ambition is a way for Hatzlacha. It's a way to have success. Success. Like the Gemara said, the Tmeim, the people that they were impure. They came to Moshe Rabbeinu, they said to Moshe Rabbeinu, we are impure. And because we were impure, we did not do the sacrifice of Pesach. So Moshe, it was not our fault that we were impure. It was not our fault. So why? Because of that, we don't have to do the sacrifice. And they had this ambition to do a sacrifice, invite, desire to do a sacrifice. It was so strong on their heart. So Moshe Rabbeinu told them, I will ask Hashem. And Hashem told them, yes, they are right. It was not their fault. The day of Pesach, that they couldn't do the sacrifice of Pesach because they were impure. It was not their fault. So because they ask, I give them another day. You see, when you have good desire, good inspiration, good motivation, and good ambitions, that give you revelation. You become, it give you revelation. You grow. And this is Be'ezat Hashem. This is the Kuach of the Matan Torah. The Kuach of Matan Torah, I am a businessman. Who I am? To ask Hashem to give me the Torah. Yes, you can ask. Have ambition. There were a lot of tzaddikim. They were businessmen. And they were big tzaddikim. Rahim HaKadosh, he was a jeweler. You know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yes, he was a jeweler. He used to do jewelry for the king. He has a jewelry shop. And he was Or HaChaim HaKadosh. A lot of tzaddikim. Hanoch, he was a shoes repair. He used to repair shoes. And he became a malach. Rabbi Yohanan HaTzandelar, Rabbi Yitzhak Napaha. A lot of tzaddikim. They were businessmen. They were workers. Hillel HaZaken, he used to work. A big tzaddikim, they work. But they had ambition to be big tzaddikim. And they were big tzaddikim. A man should not limit himself because he's a businessman. He cannot be a rabbi. He cannot be a bin Torah. No. A man can be a businessman. A man can be whatever he wants to be. And he can, with ambition to be a tzaddik, he can be a tzaddik. He can be a tamid haram. He can be a bin Torah. So, ambition. That's why the parasha of Bamidbar is quite before Matan Torah. It gives you a preparation. How to prepare yourself to receive the Torah. First, you can learn from everyone. There is a lot of to learn. Don't think you are a clever man. You are a big man. That you have nothing to learn from nobody. You can learn from everybody. There is always something to learn from everybody. That is very, very important. Don't forget that. That's why Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, you could ask Moshe Rabbeinu, count the Jews, we will know how many they are. No. Hashem said, no. Count each tribute. And each tribute where he will be camping. And each tribute with his flag. The color of the flag. The color of the stone that the Kohen Gadol was holding in his chest. Because from each one I can learn something. There is always ambition to be something. I can have ambition to be David, and on me there is all Klal Israel, all the 12 tribes on me. How? When Israel are invisible, when I love everybody, when I want to learn from everybody, when I count everybody, I don't only count myself. I count everybody. I have patience to count everybody. I would like to tell you something I finished. When you go to the plane, you see the steward, he counts people.
Yes.
He counts people individually. Why he had to count people individually? Before all those people were in the plane, the steward outside, they already count them through their tickets. Yes or no?
Yes.
So why this man has to count again? Everybody sitting, please sit, remain seated, we have to count you, 1, 2, 3, down, down, down. Why? Why this second, why? To make sure, yes or no?
Yes.
Because sometimes, maybe the electronic machine outside, maybe it's false. So they have to count again to make sure that there is the exact number. You understand?
Yes.
I think that's what exactly Hashem wants us to do. Not only to know how many we are in general, Hashem wants us to count each one. A second counting. I have to count you. You have to count me. But not only counting 1, 2, 3, 4, no. I want to know who you are. What it is that you good me do. What I can learn from you. What you can give me. A man should have ambition to have all good qualities. It's impossible to have good qualities. It's impossible for me to learn from everybody. It doesn't matter. You do what you can. Do what you can. And I would like to tell you the story of the week. When I was Be'ezat Hashem, you will hear this one of the best story. I will not tell you the name of this man, but this man is my Baal HaBayit in Toronto. He told me the story. He said that a few years ago he came to see me, and I asked him an amount of tzedakah. It was a quite big amount of tzedakah. And I told him, I need this money for Hachnasat Kala. And Be'ezat Hashem, with the zichut of this tzedakah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give you a long life. If there is any gezerah, it will be stopped. It will be stopped. There will be no gezera.
Okay.
How do you say it will be mitbatel? Postponed, yeah?
Yeah, canceled.
The gezera, Be'ezat Hashem, will be canceled. So I told him, I remember, yes, it was about 10 years ago. So I told him, you never told me that story. He said, Rabbi, can you give me the permission that this story, I will tell the story on the wedding of my son. I told him, why the wedding of your son? He said, because this story, it's with my son as well. It's a big miracle happened, not only with me, but with my son. Through the tzedakah that I give you, utzedakah tatzim mavit, the tzedakah protect from death. And you did give me, you told me to give you this amount of money, and that helped a lot to postpone the bad gezerah that did not happen. And because of that, today my son is going to be married. So I told him, tell me the story. So he told me that after that he gave me the money, he's supposed to go to New York. He had a big appointment in New York on Tuesday at 9 o'clock. Now, he had a problem. If he will go to New York on Tuesday, and if he will go to the appointment, he will miss the Slichot. Because it's Elul, you understand?
Yes.
And he promised to his son to take him to do the Slichot. And now he had a big problem. He did not know what to do. And he said to his son, I have a big problem. I have a big appointment, very important appointment, on Tuesday at 9 o'clock. And I have to be in New York. And I know what to do. I promised you to take you to the Slichot. So he said, you know, well, we will miss the Slichot, but we'll catch it another day. You come with me to New York. I take you with me to New York. That will be like a consolation for you. Pour le consoler. And Be'ezat Hashem, we'll go next time to Slichot. So his son, he was not so quite happy. So he said, okay, Papa. So this man, this Baal HaBayit, he prepared himself to go Tuesday to New York to catch the first plane to go to the appointment. And that's it. In the afternoon, he received a phone call that they told him that the appointment was cancelled instead of 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock. My balabait, his name is Chaim. He was so happy, so pleased. He said to his son, well, I have a good news for you. On Tuesday morning, we have time to go to Slichot and catch the plane. We go to New York. I will take you with me. And we go to the appointment because the appointment is not anymore at 9 o'clock. It's at 11 o'clock. And Baruch Hashem, it was a big, big good news for both of them. Okay?
Enough.
Now, on Tuesday morning, they went to the synagogue, did the slechot. From there, they went to the airport to catch the plane. They went to New York. They arrived at New York maybe at past 9. That day was September 11.
Aye.
Aye. And they had an appointment one of the tours, and the 90 stores. Au 90th étage. Now, can you imagine if he will be there, if he will go to New York on Sunday nights to be at the appointment at 9 o'clock, at 9:15, the terrorists, they destroyed the two tours. The Balabait and his son, they will be deaf. All the people that they have appointment with them, they die. This is the story that he told me. That's the story that he said in the wedding of his son, in front of hundreds of people. And he told them, if today I am here and my son is married, it's because of the tzedakah I give for the Hachnasat Kala and because of the zichut of the slichot we're here today. This is the story that he told me. He said, I didn't want to tell you, but now I decided to tell the story because I have to tell thank you to Hashem for what he did for my son, for what he did for me. This is the story. It's an amazing story. Ambition. Ambition to achieve something. The willing, the ratzon, to be close to Hashem. This man, beside the tzedakah I give, he had a big, big, big sadness to do slichot, to pray to Hashem, to be close to Hashem, to ask forgiveness to Hashem on Elul, on Chodesh Elul, few days before Rosh Hashanah. Because the Ashkenaz, they do the slichot few days before Rosh Hashanah.
Yeah.
And because when Hashem saw the sacrifice he did for the tzedakah and the sadness that he was not doing the slichot, Hashem he saved his life, that the appointment was postponed instead of being at 9 o'clock, they give him at 11 o'clock. So the time to do the slichot, to catch the plane, and to go to the office. In the meantime, the two tours were already destroyed. When Hashem sees a man having ambition, how can we help him to be tzaddik, yirish shamayim? Sh'ifa la'alot, sh'ifa l'gdol. Ambition to grow. But don't forget, the ambition, it's a matana. Like you have two eyes, like you have a heart, like you have ears, Hashem will give you another matana. The eyes that you look with, it's a matana from Hashem. It's a gift. To smell, these people cannot smell. It's a gift from Hashem. that you can smell. Ah, I smell flowers. I smell fruit. I smell perfume. It's a gift. Hashem will give you another kind of gift. Sh'ifa. The strength, the koach of ambition. The koach of ratzon. You can, if you want. They're on you. You use them. You can be a malach if you want. You can be Moshe Rabbeinu if you want. Use the koach that Hashem will give you. Sh'ifa, zigdol. The ambition to grow. The ambition to be to evaluate yourself. The ambition to be mit'alle. And this is the ambition of Shavuot. The ambition of Shavuot. To say to Hashem, Hashem, I want to be special. Hashem, I want to be. I want to grow. Hashem, give me more Torah. By having this ambition, Hashem will give you anything you want. God bless you.